name is Caroline Karemi Karioki, and I am a principal prosecution counsel. I head the children's division, which falls under the Department of Conventional and Related Crimes. Before I was in private practice, I was in insurance. It was all about desk work. And I think that is the thing that makes me really love prosecution. It's not about paper, it's about lives, it's about real people.
I'd never met a prosecutor before. I'd never known anyone as a prosecutor. But again, I applied and I went for the interviews. So when I went, by good luck, I succeeded. And then I became one. Then I was like, okay, fine. So I would imagine probably I'm the first prosecutor from Kitui County.
Initially, I wanted to be a pediatrician. But that tells you my love for children started a long way back. In my mind, I knew where children are, it must be a happy place. But the children's court is one of the places you find very sad stories, day in, day out. At some point, I even wanted to quit because I was thinking, I can't handle this. This is too much pain. It's unfair what these children are going through. But then one night I sat and I thought, but this is a platform. I have a chance to speak for this child. I have a chance to do something. I might not be able to erase the pain they have gone through, but I can stop the pain from going forward. And then I can do something to make their life better.
Being from a marginalized community, first one being a Muslim, two being a female, and three coming from the Arab community, it's such a big deal for an individual like myself to be working, and two in the public service, and three to be married and have children, but still be able to manage both lives. It's unheard of. From where I'm from, it's unheard of. Yeah, like, I would say like I'm the first one in my family to actually even work in public service. I'm always like, I wish I was able to cut myself into half and like be at two places at the same time, because I love both my lives. I love my personal life, which is very like family oriented, and then I love my job and I love coming to work and I love what I do and I enjoy it because I feel like it's my purpose.
From the time I joined prosecution, most of the cases were being defended by male advocates. Some have come very aggressively to confront me why some of their clients are in jail. So long as you prepare for your case, they will come and reach a point and have respect for you because they have seen that you can deliver.
Considering the body size, not so many people have confidence in you. Even sometimes the members of the public come and they're like, oh, this is the one who is going to deal with our case. Can I have someone different? But the minute you sit with them, you talk to them, you start advising them, when you're handling their case, they develop that confidence. Respect is earned. So when someone sees that you know what you're doing, even if you're a junior, but you know your thing, you've prepared well, you're arguing a case, it has merit. All these things about seniority and this will have a backbench.
ODPP gives us that platform. You're not just a prosecutor. You give service to everyone. That is how I even got recognized by the Anti-FGM Board Kenya, because I was always out there advocating and creating awareness against all these injustices that are met by the vulnerable people in the society. And they recognized me and gave me the Prosecutor of the Year Award on female genital mutilation in 2018. And in 2019, they came to Narok County because I told them there is a problem in this marginalized community. And they brought the inaugural end of the FGM seminar in Narok.
I feel like we're very fortunate because not many government offices look this pretty. And we're very grateful to the DPP for this act of ensuring that we're all comfortable and ensuring that we have a lactation room, we have a mosque, we have a chapel, we have enough boardrooms, I believe. We have a clinic that is in the pipeline.
He's giving young people platforms in leadership, which is something not very common in public service. Public service initially was for the older guys to take the management leadership, but he's opened a door for the young people who are willing to work hard enough. And I think that is something that needs to be lauded.
I am grateful, really grateful for me because of the opportunities that I got to do something. You know, life can be very boring when there's nothing you're doing or when no challenge is thrown your way. And I am sure that I am one of the few people who can say that if in the course of my work I was thrown a lemon, I made lemonade out of it. And I actually really, really, really appreciate the challenges because they just proved to me that I can be stronger than I really think I am.
And again, you realize in every office, in every vocation, in every profession, there must be a calling. And if you find your calling, whether being well-paying or not, you get the satisfaction you want, the job satisfaction. That is what I get being a prosecutor.